So today you guys are gonna know about something pretty cursed. Yes, the Cookie Monster, the most favorite character of Sesame Street. But before that, be sure to smash a like on today's video and subscribe to the channel. So I found some creepy dark secrets about Cookie Monster. But first, history of Cookie Monster. The Cookie Monster is one of the main characters of Sesame Street. He's covered with blue fur and possessing pair of googly eyes. Cookie Monster has a very strange appetite, as his name implies his primary craving is cookies. But he can and often does consume anything and everything he gets his hands on too. He literally will eat anything and everything, and it shows that in the show, like he will eat anything he finds. When Cookie Monster eats something, he makes a very distinct loud munching noise like nom 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 nom. In 1966, Henson drew three monsters who appeared in the General Foods commercial that featured three crunchy snack foods: Wheels, Crowns, and Floops. Each snack was represented by a different monster, as it turns out that commercial was never aired. But all three monsters had a feature in the Muppet cast, and those ended up linking in as inspiration for what eventually turned into Cookie Monster. But the secrets linked to the Cookie Monster are really dark. So before Cookie Monster became official, he went through a ton of different looks, styles, colors, and designs into the iconic blue fur, googly eyes, and normal mouth. However, at one point it was quite terrifying, because Cookie Monster actually had sharp jagged teeth, like literally razor blade teeth, and it was terrifying to the kids, so they had to cut that one. And one of the really terrifying thing about Cookie Monster is that when Cookie Monster was eating a cookie on TV, he actually was eating fake cookies. Yes! So the cookies that we see on the screen and the Cookie Monster was eating were not real cookies. Cookie Monster has eaten hundreds of cookies in his time on Sesame Street, and all of them could not be real cookies, because all the oil from the actual food would be damaging to the puppets. So the prop makers were using painted rice crackers for cookies with the advent of high definition. However, this was no longer convincing to the children, so they eventually developed a recipe for breakaway cookies that have been since used, and this recipe includes pancake mix, puffed rice, grape nuts, and instant coffee for the color, and hot glue for the chocolate chips that they put on these fake cookies, which are now prop cookies for the show whenever they have Cookie Monster eat a cookie. However, this is not where it gets strange. There is something a little creepier about this puppet. So the creepy thing about Cookie Monster's puppet is at the back of his mouth, there's a gigantic hole built into the back, so the puppeteer can create the illusion that the character is eating any number of items that go into the back of Cookie Monster's mouth. So if you wanted to try to fit inside a Cookie Monster's mouth yourself, he could even swallow an entire human with that big hole in the back of his mouth. That is surely so creepy. Like, he literally eats everything and anything. There was one episode of Sesame Street that was a collaboration with Kermit the Frog that was so scary and so concerning to the young children that this became a lost episode that they had to take off of TV and stop airing, because children were crying over this episode. It literally scared them so much. So basically, in this episode, Kermit and Cookie Monster, the two best friends, were hanging out and just talking and chatting, and Cookie Monster started to act like a bizarre wild animal. He literally started to act like a dog trying to attack Kermit, and Kermit even says during this clip, "Some people will eat anything." And then Cookie Monster just keeps on going after Kermit the Frog, attempting to grab his arms, his leg, and eventually try to swallow Kermit whole. And of course, that scared a lot of children, although he didn't successfully succeed at swallowing Kermit entirely, but he definitely wanted to. He found him to be a whole snack. Cookie Monster, you did what? Oh my god. You're my favorite childhood character. How could you do that? So another fact is that basically parents kind of found Cookie Monster to be a bad example for their kids. All he does is eat cookies, sugary food, and pretty much anything he finds okay. And kids that look up to the Cookie Monster might be like, well, I want to be like Cookie Monster. Cookie Monster eats cookies all day, so I want to eat cookies all day. Some parents are kind of dramatic about it, thinking that Cookie Monster was a bad influence, or teaching their children to eat unhealthy, not dietary sugar foods like chocolate chip cookies, and eat anything they can get their hands on, because they all of a sudden believe that they have the magic powers of Cookie Monster when they really don't. So this is like a scary and a controversial topic, but Cookie Monster is still everyone's favorite. What do you say? Anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Be sure to smash a like and hit the subscribe button. See you guys in the next video. Bye.